Mulago National Referral Hospital has reassured Ugandans that the facility has enough oxygen supply to cater for COVID-19 patients and all those in critical care. However, the executive director of Mulago Hospital, Dr. Biarugaba Baterana, has said that if the number of COVID-19 cases continue to rise, there might be a shortage. Rachel Nachuala has more.
It's not only oxygen, as people want to say, that oxygen, oxygen, oxygen. Even if there was oxygen, people would still die.
Recently, there had been unconfirmed reports that Uganda's National Referral Hospital in Mulago is experiencing a shortage of oxygen. While addressing the media today, the executive director of Mulago Hospital, Dr. Biarugaba Baterena, refuted the claims and reassured Ugandans that the hospital is equipped with adequate oxygen to cater for COVID-19 patients and other patients who require it for their critical care.
My health workers and I, we are doing our best to make sure that everybody is catered for. However, there are some issues that may come in where everybody says, why are you not, why has this one died or that one died and so forth and so forth. You know it very well that when you come late into the hospital, secondly, the outcome is not very good. And you know very well that this is the Supreme Court of Medicine, the giant of health. And we admit people who have been partially referred to Mulago Hospital quite often. People go and lay in other facilities outside Mulago Hospital. By the time they reach here, actually, they're on the best point. You find somebody's oxygen, the oxygen saturation is about like 30. Instead of say being 90, somebody is at 30. Such a person is very difficult to bring that person.
Dr. Biarugaba, however, fears that if the number of COVID-19 patients continues to rise, the hospital will have a crisis. He explained that a single COVID-19 patient consumes 70 liters of oxygen per minute, which is 10 times higher than that usually required by a patient in the intensive care unit.
The requirement of oxygen will depend on the number of patients and at what level of oxygen they require. Because you find a patient requiring 70 liters of oxygen per minute. And again, the normal patient in the normal ICU requires between 1 and 10. So one patient in the COVID ICU consumes the oxygen that would be required by 10 LFT patients in the normal ICU.
Mulago Hospital requires over 4,000 liters of oxygen per minute, yet their oxygen production capacity is only 2,083 liters. However, David Nuwamanya, the principal hospital administrator at Mulago, said other stakeholders have come on board to help the hospital meet the overwhelming demand.
We need over 4,000 liters per minute. Over 4,000 liters of oxygen per minute. And now, at normal production, we can only produce 2,083. So we are trying to bolster the capacity of the oxygen plant so that we produce more oxygen. But also, we are working with the partners to ensure that we have constant flow, constant reaching of oxygen cylinders, so that at no point do we have a break. Because as they will tell you in their demo, even if the plant was producing enough, that may not be enough to the patient. We have other limitations. Most of the equipment that we use in the world, we are calibrated for normal patients. Where the consumption is below 15, they will tell you the parameter.
The Ministry of Health plans to install another oxygen plant at Mulago next week. The plant will generate an additional 2,083 liters of oxygen per minute, doubling the capacity of the plants at the hospital.
Even if we get 15 from the wall, which is maximum, but even if we use the dual flow, we have where you can have dual flow and have two flow meters, it will give you maximum of 30. So if a patient wants more than that, it means you have to supplement using these cylinders. So at all points still now would need to fill the oxygen cylinders. So if once we increase our capacity here, then we'll be able also to refill our cylinders from here at non-peak levels. When we get non-peak levels, we use that little time to fill the cylinders and then put them in our buffer to be used in the ward.
Ugandans have been urged to keep observing the SOPs to ensure they do not get infected with COVID-19. Doctors say the availability of oxygen does not guarantee one survival in case they fall sick.
We have been telling you, honorable Ugandans, that please maintain the SOPs. But the Ugandans are not maintaining the SOPs. Yes. And I tell you, I have told you that oxygen is not a total treatment for COVID. I've told you that. The best treatment for COVID must be prevented. But for you to have COVID and you say, when they give me oxygen, I will recover. Even if you put people on the ventilator, they still continue to die.
Since the plants cannot meet the oxygen needs of all the 180 patients who need 3,600 liters of oxygen per minute, the hospital needs to refill at least 200 oxygen cylinders from other suppliers. This story was compiled by Rachel Nachiwala for the news at Mulago Hospital.